Hello friends, welcome to Devrat Knowledge Villa. You are watching our English video series of operating system and learning basics of OS. And today's our topic is batch operating system. So let's start. Before today, we have already discussed earlier system in our previous video. So let's see how earlier system was look like. So here there is our earlier system, and there was a simple processor and one common memory. In terms of input, we have produced entire job as a input, and same thing we got the output in form of job. So right now what we are going to modify, we are not making any change into the internal system, but we are going to modify the way of giving input and output. So let's see. It is our earlier system. So we are not going to modify a processor or memory. We are just going to modify the methods of giving input. Let's see the properties of batch operating system. First one, input output as batch of jobs. It means whatever our input we will produce, so we will produce input in form of entire batch in place of single job. So in terms of earlier system, we have produced single job as a input, but here we are producing set of multiple jobs as a input, and we are calling it batch. Get it? Hope you are understanding what is the modification over here. Let's see the next property. Same thing, we will get the output as a batch. Second property is input output through operator. It means here we are taking one operator which is responsible to produce input. So let's see what is the role of operator. Suppose here there are various number of jobs are available. So what operator will do? It will make a similar jobs under single batch. How? So let's see. Operator will collect all of the jobs and convert it into the separate batch. What operator will follow while converting the batch? Operator will look whatever the number of jobs are with the similar characteristics. So operator will put this type of jobs into a single batch. Like see here, job 1, 4 and 7 are in single batch. It means some of the characteristics of these jobs are similar, like this batch requires resource R1, then after job 2 and job 5 requires resource R2. Get it? Same thing, job 3, 6 and N requires resources R3. Get it? So operator will place number of different jobs into a single batch, and operator will produce this number of batches as a input to the computer system. Hope you are understanding what I want to say. Let's see next. We have discussed one example while discussing earlier system, that was a personal tuition. Suppose one professor teaching one student personally. So how many students can get the knowledge from professor? So maybe if you consider a single day, so professor can teach 5 to 7 students. But suppose we will make a batch of few students, like this 4 students want to learn any single subject. Another, these 3 students want to learn another subject. So we can categorize, or we can arrange them into a group with respect to subjects. Like, suppose you are learning in classroom, so you are learning 60 people together. But whenever you will go for the laboratory session, so you are going to divide into the number of separate batches. It is subject wise. So it is more convenient to learn and teach. Get it? Another example we have discussed, that was the load and unload of ship. Let's see here. Suppose ship is going to be load or unload. So what happens? Multiple luggage or kind of things are there, look like woods, coals, metals, etc. So suppose in a situation, if you consider one truck is arrived of wood, second truck is arrived of metal, third truck is arrived of look like some another thing, coal. Get it? So it is difficult to arrange different things at a parallelly. So hope we can make the changes, like first 10 trucks is arrived of wood, then 10 trucks will arrive for the coal, then 10 trucks will arrive of the metal. So it is easy to arrange inside the ship. Same thing, it will be followed during the unload. Get it? So hope you are getting what is the change here with respect to earlier system. Let's discuss the limitation. In terms of limitation of batch operating system, first thing is limited memory. So here, same limitation was available into the earlier system also. So here we are not going to make any change into the memory. Again, it is limited as per the previous one. Second thing, direct interaction of input output and CPU. It means till this operating system, user are not able to communicate directly with the system. It means system is not interactive. Still, IO devices are communicating with the CPU because input output is again in form of jobs. Another thing, poor CPU utilization. Like we have discussed load and unload. Many of the time of CPU are going to be waste for the loading purpose and unloading purpose. Whenever IO devices are going to load all these batch into the processor, as well as whenever output devices are going to unload all of the jobs from the CPU, at that time CPU remain idle. While what necessary arrangement can be done, like at that time CPU can serve the another process, but it is not possible because load and unload is carried out by the IO devices. Get it? Next, our comparison of batch operating system with earlier system. So look like here we are taking the properties and limitation of both cases. So what is the difference here in terms of earlier system? IO as a job. Here there are multiple jobs. It means set of jobs as a IO. In earlier system, input with the card readers and produced by the punch card and magnetic tape. Here input output produced by the operator, and all of the similar jobs are under the single batch. So that is a variation. What are the limitations of earlier system? Earlier system is not interactive. So again, batch system is also not interactive. So this limitation is not going to be overcome. Simple OS with control transfer. Same thing here, same work of the operating system. Again, it is not going to overcome. Very poor CPU utilization. Yes, here we are able to modify a little bit. Again, in terms of batch system, there is a poor CPU utilization, but it is better than earlier system. So here we are able to modify few things. Common and limited memory. So same thing is applicable to the batch system also. Hope you are understanding very well. Our next topic will be spooling, that is one more type of operating system. So let wait for the video of the spooling. Thank you very much. Stay connected with the Devrat Knowledge Villa.